Hello there, I'm Alec Fenn, and today I'm at Power League in Sunbury for the latest episode of You Ask, We Answer. If you're new to the show, it's really simple. You give us your questions and we put them to the game's best players and coaches so you can improve your game. Today we're helping out Sheriff Jallow, who wants to know how he can become a top fullback. To help him out, we've spoken to Manchester City and Brazil defender Danilo, who's got a few bits of advice to help him get underway.
Talvez se eu jogar como lateral, faz falta você aguentar mais da piques longos e voltar. Normalmente os laterais, o médio centro, são jogadores que são os que correm maiores distâncias durante o jogo, né? Então é necessário você se preparar um pouquinho mais, você descansar mais, né? Você tratar bem do seu corpo, porque você vai sempre precisar dessa reserva, né? E claro, não só além do trabalho dos clubes, que são fenomenais, ter o seu trabalho extra, que eu acho que hoje em dia é muito importante para o atleta de alto nível.
Some great advice there from Danilo. Now, to put that into action, we've linked up with top strength and conditioning coach Cameron Goff. He's worked with a host of top footballers to help them get Premier League fit, and he's going to do the same thing for us today. Cameron, great to see you. Now today I want you to help me get Premier League fit like a fullback, someone like Danilo at Manchester City. How are you going to help me do that today?
So the key components of a fullback, we're going to work on your acceleration, your deceleration, your jockeying, so you're defending, and also getting through the pitch and get to the byline.
Great, sounds pretty tough. Let's get going.
Al, so what we need to do, we're going to do a few little plyometrics. Basically, the less time on the ground, the better. So small little impacted bounds. After your first double bounce, a little lateral shuffle onto the side, go and repeat it to the end, have a little push into a little sprint. So what that's going to be is a double jump, short and sharp, over, get across, over, just a short change of direction. When you get to the end, get pushing. Good, then short and across, good. Middle, now push right, push right, now left, back to the middle, over, next one, across, little push, little push, little push. Okay, Al, so what we need to do is have a close ball control. We need to get through those cones without directly going over the top of them or through them, okay? Get round to the side, play a ball into me, attack me, now passively defend me. When I turn inside, that's your cue to go and get around me. I'm gonna play your ball down the channel. One touch tops, deliver to me, I'll be waiting in the box. Hopefully we finish. When you've done that, sprint back to the start and we go and repeat it. Go! Push, push, push. Defend, defend, defend. Yes, get round me. Have a touch. If you want, deliver. Get back, get back, get back, get back, get push. And again, let's go. Fast feet, fast feet, fast feet, fast feet. Get through, can you find me? Now go on, defend, 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 defend. Get round me, let's go. Let's go, out. Touch, touch. Push, push, push. Let's go. Fast feet, fast feet, fast feet. Yep, speed up. Now defend, now defend, now defend. Yes, get round me. Now, get a touch, get a touch, get a touch. Open your body. Deliver. Go, push, push, push. All the way back, all the way back. Well done.
Now Cam, technically and physically, that is really tough. I've got a real sweat on there. You know, just why is that perfect for fullbacks?
Fullbacks you're seeing nowadays, they're so attacking minded that they're getting down the byline, but then before they knew it, they've got to get back and defend. Because how quick people counter on the attack, they need to be basically busting their lungs to get themselves back and go and defend and help their team out. So that's great for attacking, but then you've got to stay switched on to go and defend as well, because that's your job to go and do. Okay, Al, so I want you to sprint out, defend, jockey, sprint out, defend, jockey, get the ball, jog through, play a 1-2 with me, get around the cone and finish.
can, the sort of acceleration there and the deceleration, really, really tough on the legs. I mean, that's really important, isn't it, for your modern fullback?
Oh, massively. To see the transition from attacking to defending, it's over in a split second. So we need to make sure we can attack perfectly, but then also get the back defending, then get back pushing, accelerating, decelerating. So that's continuously on the balls of your feet, moving. Very taxing on the legs.
And great as well for players who might be playing as a wing back, people like Kyle Walker. Yep. Again, perfect for that.
Exactly that, because then we're replicating his game, putting it onto the training ground, so when it comes into a match game, he's already done it.
A lot of that was real high speed work. I mean, how often should I be doing that in a week to get myself fit for a Saturday?
Because it is so taxing on the legs and that, ideally once at a very push, two times a week, depending on how your game situations and your schedule set up.
Okay, great. Top man, Cam. We'll catch you next time. Thanks, mate. There we go, that's the session finished with. Sheriff, I'm pretty sure that's going to help you get fullback fit anytime soon. Big thank you to Cameron Goff for putting on today's session. If you like the video, hit that like button. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe. If you've got any questions about today's video or any videos you want us to do in the future, please leave your questions in the comments section below. We'll catch you next time.